I would like to thank the organizers for chance to give a talk here, and I will tell about characterization of bilinear forms graphs, and this is a joint work with Jack Kulin. So let me start from some definitions and notations from graph theory. All graphs in this talk are simple, so without loops or multiple edges, and we use this notation for adjacent vertices x and y, and the distance between vertices x and y is the length of the shortest path between x and y, and d of x and y is the distance, denotes the distance. The diameter of a graph gamma is the maximum distance occurring in gamma. For a graph gamma, define gamma I of x to be the set of vertices that are distance I from x. And in particular, gamma 1 of x denotes the set of neighbors of vertex x, and I will also use this notation to denote the subgraph induced by neighbors of vertex x. Now, a connected graph gamma is called distance regular if there are numbers ai, bi, and ci such that for every pair of vertices x and y at distance I, the vertex y has exactly ci neighbors. So, first of all, y belongs to the set gamma y of x, and it has exactly ci neighbors in the set gamma I minus 1 of x, ai neighbors in the set, in the same set, gamma I of x, and bi neighbors in the set gamma I plus 1 of x. In particular, gamma is regular with valency b0, which is also the cardinality of gamma 1 of x. And the sum of ci, bi, and ai, and bi is equal to b0. for a distance regular graph gamma, we can also define the intersection numbers of gamma. We take a pair x and y, a pair of vertices at distance k, and then the cardinality of intersection gamma I of x with gamma j of y doesn't depend on the choice of vertices x and y at distance k. So this cardinality is denoted by pi jk. And in particular, the numbers ci, ai, and bi from the previous slide can be expressed in terms of these intersection numbers in this way. Also, we define the intersection array for a distance regular graph gamma as a sequence of b0, b1, and so on, bd minus 1, and c1, c2, and so on, cd. And it turns out that all the intersection numbers pi, jk can be calculated from this intersection array. So in some sense, it is a comprehensive characteristic of gamma. Now, let me recall some examples of distance regular graphs. The first example is the Hamming graph with parameters n and q. Let q and n be positive integers, q is at least 2, and capital Q is a q-element set. Then the Hamming graph with parameters n and q has as vertices all the words of length n over alphabet Q, capital Q. And two words are adjacent if they differ in exactly one position. So the Hamming distance between these words is equal to 1. The diameter of this graph equals n. And here is an example of the usual cube. This is also the Hamming graph with parameters 3, 2. In a partial case, when n equals 2, we will call the Hamming graph the lattice graph. The vertices of this graph can be represented as a lattice in which two vertices are adjacent if and only if they are in the same row or column. And more generally, we define n by m lattice as the Cartesian product of two complete graphs on n and m vertices. And I recall that a complete graph is a graph in which all vertices are pairwise adjacent. So here is an example, 3 by 4 lattice, and it is the same of, as a 4 by 3 lattice, of course. Here is a little bit more sophisticated example of distance regular graph, the Grassmann graph with parameters q and d. Let q be prime power, n and d be positive integers, then the Grassmann graph with parameters q and d has as vertices all d-dimensional subspaces of the vector space of dimension n over a finite field with q elements. And two subspaces are adjacent if and only if their intersection has dimension d minus 1. And my final example, the bilinear forms graphs with parameters q and m. Let n and m be integers, q a prime power, and then the bilinear forms graph with parameter q and m has as vertices all n by m matrices over the finite field with q elements, and two matrices are adjacent if and only if the rank of their difference equals 1. And of course, the bilinear graphs, the bilinear forms graph with parameters q and m is the same as the bilinear forms graph with parameter q m by m. And this family of graphs is closely related to the previous family because bilinear forms graphs can be considered as subgraphs of the Grassmann graphs. So we can construct the Hamming graphs, the Grassmann graphs, the bilinear form graphs with any given diameter. But there are quite few known constructions of distance regular graphs with this property. And moreover, all the primitive distance regular graphs obtained from these known constructions are Q-polynomial. And I will define this property later. It was observed by Banai in early 80s, and so he suggested the question, can we classify all the Q-polynomial distance regular graphs with large enough diameter? And still, this question may be a central problem in distance regular graph theory. I should note that, of course, Q polynomiality, this property to be Q polynomial, can be recognized from intersection array after some calculations. So one of steps towards solution of this problem is to characterize the known distance regular graphs by their intersection arrays, or in other words, to find all the distance regular graphs with given intersection array. For instance, Egawa in 81 showed that any distance regular graph with the same intersection array as a Hamming graph is indeed the Hamming graph, or if q equals 4, one of Dube graphs. So we know all distance regular graphs with intersection arrays of Hamming graphs. In 95, Metsch proved that the Grassmann graph with parameter q and d can be characterized by its intersection array except of these cases. And about 10 years ago, an exception, the twisted Grassmann graph with the same parameters as the Grassmann graph with parameter q 2d plus minus 1d for all q, was constructed by Van Damme and Kulin. But still all cases, including this case, are open. So in principle, there may be some other examples with the same parameters. Also, Match in 99 showed that the bilinear forms graphs with parameters Q, N by M, N and M can be characterized by their intersection arrays if Q equals 2 and M is at least N plus 4 and Q is at least 3 and M is at least N plus 3. So here is open cases for the bilinear forms graphs, and in this work we showed that the bilinear form graph can be characterized by its intersection array if Q equals 2 and M equals M. So we solved this case. Now in the rest of my talk I first recall an idea exploited by Match in his characterization of Grassmann graphs and bilinear form graphs. Then I will explain why this idea cannot be applied for open cases, and I will tell our approach, and I will explain why at this moment we cannot apply our approach for other open cases. Let's first understand local structure of our graphs, I mean Grassmann graphs and bilinear forms graphs. So as I said, I will use this notation to denote the local graph, the subgraph induced by the neighbors of a vertex X. And then one can show that the local graphs in the Grassmann graphs, graph with parameter Q and D are the clique extensions of lattice of this size. And in the bilinear forms graphs, the local graphs are Q minus 1 clique extension of the lattice of this size. The clique extension of a graph is a graph obtained by replacing each vertex by a clique on a certain number of vertices, and we join vertices from different cliques if their preimages are adjacent. So this local structure tells us some information about global structure of graph. In particular, we can find two families of for the Grassmann graphs and for the bilinear form graphs, we can find two families of maximal complete subgraphs or cliques. Because columns and rows of the clique extension of lattice together with vertex X give rise to two families of maximal complete subgraphs. So, in particular, in the Grassmann graphs, we have two families of complete subgraphs. One family of cliques. The cliques of one family has this size, and the cliques of another family have this size. And in the bilinear form graphs, we also have two families of maximal cliques. The cliques of one family have this size, and the cliques of another family have this size. Now we need one more definition. It's a partial linear space. A partial linear space is a set P of points and a set L of lines, or subsets of points, such that any line contains at least two points and any two lines are on at most one line. Now we can construct partial linear space from the Grassmann graphs and bilinear form graphs. We consider all the vertices of gamma, where gamma is the Grassmann graph or the bilinear form graph. We consider all the vertices of gamma as the set of points, and we consider maximal cliques of the same size in gamma as the set of lines. So then we obtain a partial linear space while gamma is its point graph. And the point graph of the partial linear space in the graph on the points of partial linear space where two points are adjacent if they are collinear. And now a key idea to characterize gamma is to recover the corresponding partial linear space. And then recognize this partial linear space, and after that we can, we can do this, we can say what is our graph gamma.
Does it also work when n is 2D?
No, I will tell why it doesn't work. For instance, this is a key result for characterizing of Grassmann graphs. The theorem by Reichert, Hurri, and Sprague. Let P and L be a partial linear space such that for some Q at least 2, each line contains at least Q square plus Q plus 1 points. Each point is on more than Q plus 1 lines. If we take a point P and line L such that the distance between P and L is 1, then there are exactly Q plus 1 lines on P meeting line L, and if P and P prime are at distance 2, then there are exactly Q plus 1 lines on P such Q plus 1 lines L on P such that the distance between P prime and L is 1. And finally, the point graph gamma of P and L of this partial linear space is connected. Then this partial linear space is isomorphic to the partial linear space formed by d-dimensional subspaces of some vector space over FQ as points and d plus 1 dimensional subspaces of this vector space as lines. So in particular, gamma is isomorphic to the Grassmann graph with corresponding parameters. But the problem is that we know only intersection array. We don't know graph gamma. So in order to construct partial linear space, we should somehow to recover this partial linear space from intersection array. In order to do this, we can use so-called Brook-Bose-Lascar match argument. This argument initially was suggested by Brook, then it was extended by Bose and Lascar, and finally improved by match. Here is only sketch of this argument, just an idea how can we construct a partial linear space. So we suppose that gamma is a graph regular with variance k, and for any pair of adjacent vertices, the number of its common neighbors is exactly lambda. And lambda should be a relatively large number. Secondly, for any pair of non-adjacent vertices, the number of its common neighbors is at most mu, and mu should be a relatively small number. And the valency k is bounded above in terms of lambda and mu. So there is a certain function of lambda and mu such that k is at most this function of lambda and mu. We also call a clique of gamma grand if it contains at least some certain number of vertices depending of k, lambda, and mu. Again, there should be some function, but I don't give an exact formula because it's not so important for this point. And then If these conditions hold, then each pair of adjacent vertices is contained in exactly one grand clique, and this clique can be considered as a line. And a number of grand cliques containing fixed vertices is bounded above, of course, in terms of k lambda and mu again. So this argument allows us to find grand cliques with these properties that every pair of adjacent vertices is contained in exactly one grand clique. And then, of course, we should prove some additional properties of our partial linear space like this. But this is the starting point for the proof. And in terms of intersection arrays, we know that k is B0, lambda is A1, and mu is C2. So if some inequalities in this argument hold, I mean, if this inequality holds, if this inequality holds, then we can apply this argument and find something similar to partial linear space. But so why do we have open cases? Because we have two problems with this argument. The first problem is that for Grassmann graphs with parameters q and d, when n is close to d, and for the bilinear forms graphs with parameters q and m, when n is close to m, this argument doesn't work. So, as we know, in case for the Grassmann graphs, in case n equals 2d plus minus 1, we have the twisted Grassmann graph. But the twisted Grassmann graph is not the point graph of any partial linear space. So it's not only technical or arithmetical problem. When in this situation, we know that we don't have to have partial linear space. And the second problem is suppose that we have determined the local structure of a graph. But in case of equality, when n equals 2d and n equals m, for the Grassmann graphs, for the bilinear form graphs respectively, we cannot guarantee the existence of a partial linear space, because all maximal cliques have the same size. So we cannot pick out a family of grand cliques which covers all the points. And we have the actual example, the folded Johnson graph. It's a graph the vertices of which are the pairs of complementary n subsets of two n element set with two vertices x and y, and x, y, x prime, y prime adjacent if and only if the intersection of x and x prime contains either one or n minus one elements. So in this case, one can show that the local graph is n by m lattice, but again, in this case, gamma is not the point graph of any partial linear space. So even if we know exactly the local structure of our graph, we cannot construct the partial linear space. Okay, so suppose we want to characterize the bilinear forms graph with parameter q and n by m. Then we face both problems. And in our work, we used some deeper theory, not only combinatorial arguments, but also we know that the bilinear forms graphs are Q polynomial, and the subconstituent algebra theory developed by Terwilliger and his group also has some consequences of this Q polynomial property which we used. So now I'm going to explain what we did, but I should recall some facts from some basic facts from distance regular graph theory. So first of all, the adjacency matrix of a graph gamma is the matrix index by is the matrix whose rows and columns index by the vertex set and xy entry. The xy entry of this matrix is equal to 1 if the vertices x and y are adjacent and 0 if they are not adjacent. The eigenvalues of a graph are the eigenvalues of its adjacency matrix. And a graph gamma regular, which is regular with valency k, has k as an eigenvalue. And non-principal eigenvalue is an eigenvalue having an eigenvector orthogonal to the all one vector. In principle, if gamma is regular but is not connected, k is considered as non-principal eigenvalue. And finally, for a graph gamma and vertex x of gamma, the a local eigenvalue at x is an eigenvalue of its local graph. That is an eigenvalue of the subgraph induced by the neighbors of x. Now let gamma be a distance regular graph with diameter d and on v vertices. We define a distance I matrix AI of gamma. The x and y entry of this matrix is equal to 1 if the distance between x and y is one, is I and 0 otherwise. And in these terms, A1 is just the adjacency matrix of gamma. Then by the definition of distance regular graph, we have this equations, matrix equations for matrices A1 and so on AD, where so the product of A1 AY and AJ is a linear combination of AK with P with coefficients PIJK, the intersection numbers. In particular, this equation implies that there exist polynomials pi of degree I such that the matrix AI is the value of this polynomial, of the polynomial pi of on AI, A1, sorry. Further, one can show that the matrices A0, A1, and so on, AD share exactly D plus 1 maximal common eigenspaces, and we define EJ to be the orthogonal projection onto the eigenspace WJ. We have this equation, I mean the matrix AY can be represented as a linear combination of E0, E1, and so on, ED with coefficients theta ij, where theta ij is an eigenvalue of AI on the eigenspace WJ. And these matrices E0, E1, and so on, ED are called the primitive idempotents. Further, one can show that there exist numbers Q, I, J, K such that the entry-wise product of matrices EY and EJ can be represented as linear combinations of EK with coefficients IJK. So we have some analogy between the matrices AI and EI, and we can continue this analogy and suppose that for some ordering of E0 and so on ED, this equation, which is similar to this equation, holds. If So if this equation holds, then this implies that there exists polynomials Qj of degree j with respect to the entry-wise product such that Ej is the value of Qj on the matrix E1. In this case, gamma is called Q polynomial. So this is the definition of Q polynomial distance regular graph. But it turns out that all known families of primitive distance regular graphs with unbounded diameter are Q polynomials. So it's very important, very important condition. Now let gamma be a Q polynomial distance regular graph with diameter d at least 3. Tirvilliger in early 90s showed that there exists a polynomial, say p t of degree 4, such that for any vertex x of gamma and any non-principal eigenvalue eta of gamma 1 of x, we have that the value of p t on eta is non-negative. Moreover, pt, this polynomial only depends on the intersection numbers of gamma in the Q polynomial ordering of E0, E1, and so on, ED. So we call this polynomial the Tirvilliger polynomial. Actually, this polynomial was mentioned in lecture note on Tirvilliger algebras, but this result has not been really published. But Tirvilliger showed the existence of this polynomial, I would say implicitly. In our work, we explicitly calculated this polynomial. So it has the following form, so we can represent this polynomial as the product of some polynomial P1 by P2 minus the polynomial P3 square. The polynomials P1 and P3 are quite simple, but the polynomial P2 is awful. This is an exact formula for this polynomial, and here theta star is the dual eigenvalue corresponding to the primitive idempotent E1. Now let gamma be a distance regular graph with the same intersection array as the bilinear form forms graph with parameters Q and by M. Then the Tirvilliger polynomial, its Tirvilliger polynomial has the three distinct roots, minus Q minus 1, minus 1, and this root of multiplicity 2, while the leading coefficient of this polynomial is negative. So we have something like that. And we know that for local eigenvalues, this polynomial should be non-negative. So local eigenvalues of gamma 1 of x can be inside this interval or only this or this point. We have that a local non-principal eigenvalue eta of at any vertex x of gamma either belongs to this interval or equal to this value. Now let Q be 2. Then we have that a local non-principal eigenvalue eta at any vertex x either belongs to this interval or equals 2 to the powers n minus 3. as a first step, we can show that gamma 1 of x, the local graph, has only integral eigenvalues. That is minus 3 or minus 2 or minus 1 or this value. So we should recall that the eigenvalues of a graph are algebraic integers, and their product, while their product is an integer. So if eta 1 and so on, eta s are all the irrational eigenvalues of gamma 1 of x, then we have that eta I is between minus 3 and minus 1, and the product of all these irrational eigenvalues is an integer, and this product is also an integer. But since eta I is in this interval, so we have this inequality, and this yields that this product is zero. So this means that we don't have any irrational eigenvalue. And gamma 1 of x may have only integer eigenvalues. But we know that gamma 1 of x has only integer eigenvalues, but we don't know their multiplicities. Now we should find their multiplicities, and we should recall one more basic fact about from the spectral graph theory. Let theta 0 with multiplicity m0, theta 1 with multiplicity m1, and so on, theta s with multiplicity ms be the spectrum of a regular with valency k graph on v vertices, and a be its adjacent symmetrix. Then we have these three equations. The sum of all multiplicities equals v, the number of vertices. The sum of all eigenvalues is equal to the trace of the adjacent symmetrix, that is zero, and the sum of the squared eigenvalues equals the product of the number of vertices and the valency of gamma. And so we may think that theta zero is k, and moreover, if the graph is connected, we also know that m zero is one. Now we can show that gamma 1 of x has this spectrum. We just apply the previous fact to our case. So we have these values for, this is the valency, theta 0, or this is the same as A1 intersection number. Theta 1, theta 2, theta 3, and theta 4 we know from the previous claim, but we don't know their multiplicities. And so we have the system of three linear equations with respect to four unknowns, m1 and so on, m4. But it turns out that this system has only one non-negative integer solution. So we can now, so this allows to determine exactly the spectrum of gamma 1 of x. So now we know that gamma 1 of x is a regular graph with exactly three distinct eigenvalues. We have only three distinct eigenvalues. It's well known fact that in this case gamma this graph is a distance regular graph with diameter 2, or which is also called a strongly regular graph. From this spectrum we can deduce that this graph has the same parameters as the lattice graph, as the Hamming graph, with parameters 2 to the power n minus 1, and it's also quite well known fact in distance regular graph theory that in this case this graph is indeed the lattice graph with these parameters. So it's just 2 to the power n minus 1 by 2 to the power n minus 1 lattice, our neighbor, our local graph. But as I explained before, we cannot recover a partial linear space in this case. So we know that our graph has the same local graphs as the bilinear form graphs, bilinear form graph. So in other words, for any vertex x of the bilinear forms graph capital B and any vertex x of gamma, we have an isomorphism from the ball of radius 1 with center at x to the ball of radius 1 with center at x in gamma. Then we were able to show that this isomorphism may be extended to the isomorphism phi prime between the balls of radius 2. And moreover, for any vertex y, for any neighbor in the bilinear form graphs, this the restriction of this isomorphism on the ball of radius 1 with center at y is also extendable. This enables us to use the theorem by Munimasa and Spektorov. This theorem shows that in this case gamma is isomorphic to the bilinear form graph. Actually, in order to use the theorem, we need to check some additional technical arguments which hold in our case. So it's quite important step, but in order to explain how to extend this isomorphism, I need some more deeper combinatorial arguments, so it's quite difficult to explain in talk. So this is essentially a sketch of our proof. I have five minutes. So I briefly explain problems which we have for if we want to solve next case. For instance, k equals 3. So the first question is suppose that gamma has the same parameters as this bilinear forms graph. The first question is, does gamma 1 of x, the local graph, have only integer eigenvalues? In this case, this polynomial, the trivial polynomial, tells us that non-principal eigenvalues belongs either to either this interval or equal this value. So at least we need to modify our first claim to show that the eigenvalues are integers. The second question is, does the local graph has this spectrum? Again, we should consider the similar system of equation with respect to multiplicities, even if we can answer this question. But in this case, we have four distinct eigenvalues, and probably it will be more difficult. Third question is the local graph the two-click extension. The problem is that in a case when q equals 2, we have that the local graphs are strongly regular graphs, which can be characterized by its spectrum. But the click extensions of lattices, it's not known whether these graphs are characterized by its by their spectrum. And moreover, I know that, for instance, 3-click extension of 3 by 3 lattice is not characterized by its spectrum. So at least I know one counterexample for this situation in general. And finally, we should, even if we answer all previous questions, we should show an the existence of extendable isomorphism between balls of radius 1. And it's also not easy because the local structure of the bilinear form graphs when q equals 2 is much simpler than the local structure of this graph when q equals 3. So every step of our proof should be modified for the next case. I have one more problem to explain, and one more problem. It's also quite interesting problem. So related to the bilinear form graphs, there is this intersection array, which is feasible for all integers m at least 6. But the only known graphs with this array are the bilinear form graphs with parameters 2, 3 by m, where capital M is 2 to the powers m. So the first open case, m equals 6, was ruled out by Juricic and Vidali 2 years ago by counting some triple intersection numbers. So now the first open case is m equals 7. And of course, m equals 8 is the bilinear form graphs. And this graph is unique, as we already know. And also by result of match, we may assume that m, capital M is at least, is at most 132. What if we apply the Terwilliger polynomial to this intersection array? For the first case, m equals 6, as I said, this case was ruled out by Juricic and Vidali, we can show that the spectrum of the local graph would be this sequence of eigenvalues and multiplicities. But it turns out that this spectrum is infeasible. This graph has only 4 distinct eigenvalues. So this means that the number of triangles through any vertex should be the same. And we can calculate this number from this spectrum. But it turns that this number is non-integer. So it gives very, very short proof of this result. But of course, Juricic and Vidali proved a more general result. It's just a partial consequence of their result. But somehow this polynomial helps in this case. For the first open case now, we also can show that the local graph would have this spectrum, also 4 distinct eigenvalues. But unfortunately, this spectrum is feasible. So the number of closed walks through a fixed vertex is integer. It can be calculated in this way, and it is integer for all, even L, and even integer for all odd L. So, unfortunately, in this case, we cannot solve using the Terwilliger polynomial. But it's quite interesting question whether this graph exists or not. So, I'm finished. Thank you for your attention.